70% of life is in the ocean, and we have only explored 5% of the ocean. So when we're talking about life and biology, I think it's a little rich to make grandiose claims about the nature of life, biologically speaking, in a quantitative fashion, in absolute terms, when 70% of it is in the ocean, and you've only looked at 5 to 10% of the ocean. You have to recognize that when people speak about science and religion, they're not speaking about science and religion, they're speaking about philosophical naturalism. They're speaking about all that exists are things that can be measured, whether with current technology or with future technology. It has to be measured at some point in time. And that is all there is to existence. There's no such thing as ghaib, as the unseen. And they equivocate between quality and quantity. The two things are the same. So when I look at somebody's brain activity and I say I'm looking at their thoughts, that's not really true. When I say I'm looking at brain activity, I'm just looking at brain activity. That doesn't mean I'm looking at their thoughts. Thought is a quality. Can you tell somebody if they're in love just by measuring certain areas of the brain? No, you can't. Love is a quality. It's an experience. It's in the realm of phenomenology. It's something else. You have to deconstruct the discourse, science versus religion, into the paradigms, first of all, that they're operating within and the philosophical assumptions that they're making. And once you do, that's when you'll start to realize that actually there's no clash between the two fields. It's a clash between worldviews. In fact, most scientists, historically speaking, have been religious. And even today, there is a lie that keeps perpetuating that most scientists are atheists. If you look at the last Pew poll done on this, by the way, only 17% of scientists identify themselves as atheists. The rest identify themselves on a spectrum. But outright atheists, most scientists are not. I hope that answers the question. I mean, that's really all there is to say about it. It's not as complicated or as scary of a subject as people try to make it to be. It's very simple. The conflict is between Iman and Kufr. It's not between religion and science. And the language people use, they're trying to just, they're sneaking it in underneath and say it's either you choose science or religion. No, they're telling you either you choose faith or disbelief.